I'm here with Oakland County Executive Brooks Patterson, and we're talking about Michigan, the Michigan no-fault insurance system, and whether it should be preserved or changed. Mr. Patterson, with the insurance industry today pushing so hard for changes, why do you support Michigan's no-fault system?
How do I love it? Let me count the ways. It's unique in America, and it's proven its worth time and time again. Without it, I would fear that people that I've met along the way, whether it's Erica Colson or even one of my own guys who was in an auto accident, as I was, were not covered by the no-fault. We have workers' comp since we were on duty.
You were on the job.
So yeah, we were on the job. But assume that we got in a situation where it wasn't duty-related, we would have been reverted to that fund. You cut off that kind of financial support over time. I mean, over a short period of time, you're going to go through the cap, weeks. And then you're going to end up in some Medicaid state-funded nursing home never to be seen again, and you're going to wither up and die. People who've been in these kinds of accidents need intensive care, will need intensive care for the rest of their life. This fund provides an essential service, a quality of life. I think that's how we should treat our citizens. And it's been on the ballot twice. Insurance companies put the question out twice, and the public has soundly defeated. Public appreciates what this fund offers citizens who have catastrophic accidents. And then the other cap that Lund is talking about is $1 million. Well, I think Jimmy went through his cap. Now, again, we're not under that fund. We're under workers' comp. Probably.
When you say you mean you yourself and your driver from
the
auto accident?
Yeah, I had some serious injuries. I'm still recovering from my driver, unfortunately. Had some damage to his neck, and he's now a quadriplegic.
I'm sorry.
It's terrible. But since we were on duty working, there's a different fund. It's called workers' comp in the state.
Now, what I don't think a lot of people realize is, in addition to the good jobs in healthcare, there's a whole issue of quality of care. That people in Michigan who suffer catastrophic injuries have a much better quality of care than people in other states without no fault. Have you come to the same?
Oh yeah, and I haven't done a nationwide search at all, but I've talked to people. I know that Florida is in fact interested, and I just sent a letter off to the insurance commissioner down there and invited them from Florida to bring a delegation to Michigan. I want to show them what we're doing with Medical Main Street here in Oakland County, and then of course the people from the No Fault Fund want to show they're interested in modeling their state after what we've got here, because the reputation for the delivery of health care that you just pointed out is excellent. And you just got to take better care of these people. There's no human reason why you want to put them in a warehouse and just let them wither up and die.
Is what happens in many other states.
Yeah,
without no
exactly what happened. Why would you want to take that away from those people? Why would you want to take away the last ray of hope that they might recover and have a modicum of a quality of life after they've been rendered paraplegic?